Hey everyone, this is Clint, and this is going to be a really difficult video to make, I think for a few reasons, but I think this is a really important topic that kind of has to be brought up, and that is, what happens if you get screwed on a crowdfunding campaign? And that could happen on many levels. One, it could be that you are just a backer of the campaign, and in that case, that's too bad, you're out. The money you spent, anywhere from $20 to $50 to $100 to $1,000, you could be out because you backed a crowdfunding campaign that never got fulfilled. Also, you could be somebody that is maybe part of a creative team. You're not running the campaign, but you're supposed to get paid. You know, this scenario can go down a lot of different ways. Ultimately, this still comes down to managing a business. And I will say that it is more difficult than I think it's given credit for. And I don't just mean running a business. I mean, doing crowdfunding as a business, doing comics, this creative art thing is a business. It is difficult. It's been sort of easy to think of it as like the streets are paved with gold now, you know, and everything's great. All the crowdfunding campaigns are super successful. I'm telling you, that's not true. And I think 2020 is going to underline that even more, partially because the competition is going to get so much more fierce this year. I've already seen so many new crowdfunding campaigns. I think it's going to be relentless on Indiegogo for the rest of the year. Now, if you're a consumer and you're out looking for crowdfunded books, this could be a great thing because you're going to see a lot of good campaigns, and hopefully people are competing against one another, and you're going to see some better artwork than you're normally used to seeing. You're going to see bigger campaigns, maybe bigger page counts, a lot of things that you might be seeing, and you have every reason to be excited as things move forward. On the other hand, if you're a small creator, understand that anything you do can destroy your chances of ever making comics again, unless you want to do it for free on your own time. Anything can destroy your chances. All right, so this was posted on Twitter. This is Critias. Critias, I don't really know him personally super well. I think maybe we've been on a stream once together, maybe something like that. But obviously I've seen him around. He did the Detective Dead story that was on Indiegogo and made about 38 grand. We will look at that. But he did announce that over the weekend that he's not going to be fulfilling the campaign because he ran out of money. He streamed with Antonio Bryce on Akari Press. That's the name of the YouTube channel, Akari Press, with Antonio Bryce. And he explained the numbers and where the money went. Two, I didn't see it live, but I know a bunch of people were there. I assume a crowd of people were there that were Detective Dead backers, and they were looking for answers. Now, I think the good news is that from what I've seen, everything that went down during this campaign is what I would call a preventable mistake. Generally speaking, it's pretty rare if you do a crowdfunding campaign and something just happens to you and that is beyond your control. There are only a few things I could see that could possibly go wrong. I would have nightmares about these kinds of things. But maybe if you ordered books, you got them printed, you're right down at the end of your dollar amount, you've got the rest of the money you're setting aside for shipping, and all of your books are on a pallet or two pallets, and they all like blow up in flames or something, or someone steals them. That would be extremely unlikely and extremely tragic. Still, I'll tell you, once I had Downcast 1, I had all the books there. That's immediately what I was thinking, is somehow these are going to get damaged. And so I tried to make sure that they were all safe. And then not only that, but I wanted to get them all shipped out so I would not have to worry about anything like that happening. Thankfully, I got the campaign fulfilled on time or early, and everything went fine. But there are a few things that can go down that can, you know, maybe you've got an artist or something, they die, you know, in the middle of the campaign. That's kind of extreme, but that absolutely can happen. And then your promises are going to be changing. In this case, Critias, well, first let me read what he said. Then I want to look over at his campaign. Again, all this is public information. That's why we're talking about it. Not only that, but it is important. All right, so Critias says here on Twitter, I can never do any more books, stories which I had written out as DD, which is Detective Dead, got made. Even my collabs with other artists are no longer doable because my reputation is mud. The consequence is that I can no longer tell stories with great people ever again. No one trusts me anymore. That is true. I think that's kind of an understatement too, frankly. I think there's probably more going on behind the scenes. I'll be honest, I'm not sure what legal consequences there are. in backing a crowdfunding campaign. It, to me, the whole thing feels like such a gray area. I was under the impression when I first started backing campaigns, like even on Kickstarter years ago, that it was sort of a hope and a prayer, and you were going to invest. It was almost like an investment. You would give some money and then see if you're going to get something back for your money. And that wasn't always the case. And so it was a crapshoot. For a while there, it felt like you could do no wrong on Indiegogo. You're going to get your book, although sometimes extremely late, which is also, I think, very damaging to a creator's reputation. But late is so much better than nothing at all. All right, so I want to go over some obvious things here. First off, $38,000 seems like an awful lot of money. It is an awful lot of money. I don't want to downplay this at all. But also, 1,153 backers is a lot of backers for that much money. Shipping alone is going to cost probably between $7,000 and $8,000 just on shipping. And I'm basing this off of how my shipping went and how expensive it was for my campaign, which was $31,000. This is absolutely real. It's going to cost several thousands of dollars just for shipping. The shipping is not in addition to this, even though, you know, you might pay shipping separately when you back a tier. This total here includes the shipping number. So you have to understand, Indiegogo is going to take their cut. You've got to keep an awful lot of money set aside for shipping. It's going to be very expensive. Printing is a whole other matter. It depends on the printer he's working with. It depends on how many versions of the book are being printed. All right, one other thing is that this is a very traditional, it's a traditional setup, I guess, creative team for the book. You've got a penciler on this book and a separate inker. In many indie comics, and I think most indie comics far and wide, they don't have a separate penciler and a separate inker. That is a relic of the past. Maybe that happens sometimes, but you have to understand how much more expensive that is than to just hire one person. If you are Marvel or DC traditionally, you could afford to do things this way. It makes sense, I guess. It's, you know, that's how things work. But in a crowdfunded book, not so. It's going to be extremely expensive because you're paying two separate people a page rate, and they're not going to be cutting you a deal on it because it's not like they're doing more work. You're going to be better off just getting somebody that can do line art. That is just the harsh reality of life. That's how it is. All right, the other thing here is it's a 132-page graphic novel. I would love to write a 132-page graphic novel. That would be amazing. That would be fantastic. But it would be extremely expensive as well. Can it be done? Yes, it can be done. But as a consumer, you'd kind of want to look and decide, is it too good to be true? In this case, I made a video a long time ago and I was trying to find something on it. And I was sort of perplexed at how he made this work, 132 pages with a full creative team, inker, penciler, colorist, letterer, you know, additional cover artists. How is he going to pay for all that with 132 pages and he's only got $38,000? There's a misconception that you can pay for, like, you get what you pay for and you're going to pay for the most expensive artist that you can find or the most expensive creative team, and it'll pay you back because you'll get more backers because of it. That's not exactly true. It's true to a point. You can get better artwork and you're more likely to get more people backing your project. At the same time, we're talking about indie comics here. We're talking about crowdfunded indie comics. You're really not looking at a massive pool of people. Now, 1,153 backers is pretty great. That's a great number. I think Brian Polito is making a very nice living off of roughly the same number of backers on some of his campaigns. And so it's nothing to sneeze at. Could this project have been done? Yes, but not with these numbers. I would have bumped the page number down to probably 66 pages. I think that's still a big chunk. That's a big bite to take. But 66 pages could do you. You know, like you could do it. It would be still a great thing, especially if you're paying, let's see, Detective Dead bundle, $20 per book. Again, profit margins are a bit of a problem there. What I don't want to get to is I'm not trying to armchair quarterback what was going on here. But I think it's important to look at these kinds of things. Now, if somebody is posting up a 132-page graphic novel on Indiegogo and they say that the whole thing's done and you're seeing, you know, pages, samples, if they say that it's done, that's a different matter that should give you a lot more confidence. I know it gives me a lot more confidence because it's going to take an awfully long time to make that size of a book. The other thing is if you're dealing with a creator that has done a crowdfunded project before, and maybe this is going to be a little bit bold, but not somebody that has worked in comics before, somebody that has specifically done a crowdfunder before, because working in comics and getting paid a page rate is very, very different than being the sole publisher of a book and getting that thing out to people. It's an entirely different skill set. Yes, you're going to have some of the comic creation part, but most of your effort is actually going to be as the publisher of the book. All right, so what does this do to consumer confidence? I think Critias is right. He's not going to be able to do this again unless he can find, I mean, even then, man, I don't see how you can come back from this and continue to make comics and get people to back them and trust them. I'm not going to say it's impossible. I think that there's probably a road out. You could find a road out. But when the perception is that you took $38,000 from backers and gave them nothing, you can't win from that one. Now, to be fair, Critias says that he is planning on finishing the book and also refunding all those people. If you're a backer of Detective Dead, my suggestion would not to, I wouldn't hold your breath over it, because that's a huge promise. And finishing this and making this promise happen, the 132 page graphic novel for $20, that's already a big promise. Refunding everybody on top of finishing that is twice as big of a promise, because he's got to figure out a way to refund all of that money and then also have enough money to continue making the book. All right, so what to learn from this? If you're going to be doing your own project, you've got to find ways to give people to trust you. You need trust. That's at the end of the line. There is no publisher that's putting themselves out there for you. It's just you. You are the man. You've got to find a way to build trust enough for people to pay you whatever you're asking for, so that you can make your book. Not only that, but you're going to have to figure out how to do it in a shorter time period. I think the big, long, in-demand phases, waiting for years for a book, that destroys consumer confidence. I hope that none of this is like revelation, but it's the truth. Now, if you're a backer, generally speaking, I think I've done pretty well. I've got to look at the list of books that I've backed. I'm still waiting for several. I'm not worried. I haven't seen any red flags yet, but I think I should look through my list of people that I've backed. What I'd like to see is, instead of internet mobbing on Twitter being the solution, I think it's a stupid solution. It shouldn't be, this makes me think of like getting, spanked as a kid. I would rather be spanked when I was a kid. I could handle a spanking, but I didn't want other kinds of punishment, because it was only going to last for a minute. It's the same kind of thing, like on Twitter, getting yelled at for a week on Twitter. I mean, that's not fun, but you'll survive. Making some kind of list, I think of like the Better Business Bureau, something like that, making some kind of list so that which creators have good scores. There's got to be some way to review creators. I do wish that Indiegogo had some kind of feature like that, where you could give feedback to those creators based off of how they handled their campaign. Did you get your product yet? There's a number of things. And I know that makes people feel icky about getting reviews. Frankly, though, I think it's important. I just hate hearing of cases like this where people are trying to get a book and it's done. The money was spent on a number of things. A lot of it, I think most of it was spent on art, but some of it was spent on paying the rent. That's not acceptable until after the book is done. Once the book's done, then you got profit. And that's cool. But yeah, all of this to being preventable is sitting down with a calculator, doing the math, getting solid page rates from people that you're hiring, making sure that you've written it all out, you've done the numbers, and then you've added on a buffer, because there are things that come up. Freaking packaging tape, that costs money. I was surprised at how much I spent on packaging tape. Buying the mailers, those are expensive too. And the longer a project goes on, you think, well, it's in demand, it's making more money. The longer a project goes on, the more money you're spending to keep things operating. It's true. You find expenses, they come up. As long as things are going, you're going to have to continue to find people, to pay people to keep things running. It is absolutely a business. So the best thing to do is don't take a payment until after the thing is finished. Once it's finished, you can take the extra. And even then, keep some aside, because you're going to have some damaged books that'll show up. You're going to have some books get shipped back to you that have faulty addresses. all that kind of stuff, you have to keep some kind of a buffer. So yeah, this was unfortunate. It's a case of, I think, high hopes biting off more than he could chew, and mismanaging money, frankly. I mean, I don't know how else to put it. So I'd love to know what your thoughts are on all of this. Again, I'm not trying to, you know, I'm not trying to stir the pot, but I do think this is important. I've been kind of surprised that I haven't seen more of these come up. I expect that there will be more coming up. If you're not getting enough money, if you ran a crowdfunding campaign, best thing to do is just return the money. You should do the math ahead of time. If you can't do it, you return the money. That's the best. And I've seen creators do that. I can't think of the one. There was one that happened. They had to change artist and they just refunded the money. That is the right thing to do. I know, kind of a different video, kind of sad. But yeah, if you enjoy this content, please give me a like. Did you notice I have some new audio? Let me know how the audio sounds. I'm hoping to improve things a little bit more. So yeah, do let me know, and I will see you next time.